Hey everybody, this is Nick. I got a great viewer question over from Yuri on a Facebook group, a PowerPoint Facebook group that I'm a part of, and we were doing some back and forth. He was trying to accomplish a morph sequence in a few slides that looks kind of like this. So he wants the picture to grow on slide number 2, and then he wants it to slide over with this sort of nice graphical slider effect. So what he wants to do again, we want to go from the first slide, which is the small photo, we want to grow it like this, and then we want it to put it on this little slider effect like this. Now, we were going back and forth, and he was getting so close. These are the slides that he sent me. He got the photo to grow, but then you can see the shape, that graphical shape in the background, and you can still see the borders right there, and then you can see that it slides over there, but you still see those borders of the shape. And on the slide number 2, this is slide number 1, this is slide number 2, those shapes automatically appear, and then you can see the borders, those little corners that kind of stick out over the top. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to make this from scratch. I'm gonna try to make it simple, but on the first slide, I wanna try to make sure that all of the ingredients are there. All of the shapes and all of the things that we have are there, because morph, when you have a morph transition, the thing that you want, all of the different objects and photos and things like that that you have on the final slide also need to be there on the first slide. They need to be throughout the entire sequence. They don't need to be in the same position. Of course, they can be hidden, they can be off to the side, they can be anywhere, but the things that you have at the end, most often with morph, you need to have at the start as well. That's how things can be easily explained, I think. So the first thing that I noticed when I got Yuri's test slides here is that he has this really nice background, this photo background in the slide. So if I right click and say format background, you can see over here it says that the fill is a picture or a texture fill. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I know that I need to have a copy of this photo to hide some things later on down the line. So let's go ahead and just copy this slide and save it as a picture. So you can just do this with nothing on it. Go to File, and then Save As, and then Browse, and then you're going to go ahead, instead of PowerPoint file, you're gonna save this slide as a JPEG or a PNG. You'll save the slide just as it is as an image file. Now, once you do that, you can go ahead and you can insert that photo just like you normally would insert any photo onto a PowerPoint slide. You can go ahead and insert from picture, and you can say this device, and then you can navigate to where that photo is and insert it. And it should look just like this. This is the one that I added right here. It's exact copy of the background, and I can put it right on top. Now, the other thing that I want to do for this tutorial is make sure that you know about the selection pane. So go to the Home tab, click on Select, and then go to the selection pane. This is where everything that you put onto the slide, you can see in this little selection pane over here on the right. And you can see that right now we just have this background. It's a picture. I've already renamed it as background. If you put a picture here, it'll probably say something like picture 2 or picture 1. But you can go ahead and just click in here and type in this so that you can change the name of the objects that you put in the slide. It's a little helpful tip, especially in morph sequence, because then you can know which object is which throughout. Okay, so that's what we need here. We're also gonna need his photo. So I'm gonna go to his first slide here and just Control C, copy that photo and put it right on top of the slide there. And then the other thing is I know that I'm gonna need some of these shapes for a graphical image. So I think that the best shape to use here is that sort of arrow pentagon. So we're gonna go to the Insert tab, go to the Shapes drop-down menu, and right down here under Block Arrows, you can see this arrow here that has a flat edge on the left and then the arrow edge on the right. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to put this here on the slide. We're gonna fill it with gray and fill the outline there just like he had it. Now the thing is, eventually we're gonna size it so it's kind of like this. But for the purposes of this slide number 1, we actually wanna hide this behind the photo. So I'm gonna go ahead, hold the Shift key and just resize it. I'm gonna put it in the middle there. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move the photo to the front. So you can do that a couple different ways. So click on that photo, right click, and you can say bring to front. You can do that and it will come to the front layer. Or you can go over here to the selection pane and you can see now I have an arrow pentagon on layer number 1, I have the picture on layer number 2, and I have that background image that I put there as layer number 3. So if I take my picture right here and I drag it up to the top layer, now you can see the photo is in front and the arrow is behind. Now that's a pretty cool trick. The other thing that we can do is we can go ahead and select multiple objects with the selection pane. So if you hold down the Control key and you select objects, you can see that now they're all selected. Now every single object is selected. So you can do that with multiple objects if you want to resize resize some things. And in fact, we're gonna do that on this next slide. So let's go ahead and duplicate our slide. Control D to duplicate this slide. I'm gonna go ahead to the transitions tab already and just apply the morph transition to slide number 2. So perfect right there. And now what I want to do is I want to make sure that this photo I want to make this photo a little bit bigger and then move it off to the right of the slide. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take the photo over on the selection pane, hold down the control key, and I'm going to click on the arrow as well. I'm going to make all of these larger by holding the shift key and then dragging this out like this. And then we're going to go ahead and move all these objects over here. Now you can see that gray shape is kind of sticking out from behind. That's okay. I'm going to go ahead and just select that, and we're going to go ahead and position this so that it is exactly in the position that I want right here. And what we can do is kind of move this out a little bit if we wanted to do that. You can see that once you drag the arrow, it's going to take a bit of a different shape. So you want to make it the corners a little bit equal there. So I'm going to go ahead and just do it like this so that we can see how that works. And that photo, I think that looks like pretty good. The photo I'm actually just going to place right over top of that chevron or over that pentagon arrow right there. So that's going to look pretty good. Now the thing is, if I were to go up to the preview tab now in the morph transition, it's going to show me what this looks like, and you can see the arrow is right there. Now the thing is, what I want to do is I actually want to hide that arrow. I want to hide the arrow, and what I can do is I can actually do that with the photo. So the pentagon arrow, I'm actually going to put that background image right above the pentagon arrow. Now when I do that, it goes away. So let's go ahead and preview this and see what happens. Now you can still see that that arrow kind of pops up there. The reason is because on the first slide, slide number 1, the layering is not correct. The photo is still in the very background. So let's go ahead and drag the background photo up above the arrow. And now let's go back to slide number 2 and push preview and see what that looks like. Excellent. Now everything is in the appropriate layer, and we've hidden that background arrow. We already moved our background photo above that arrow. Now what we're going to do is we're going to crop it. On slide number 2, we're going to crop the photo just to the point at which the arrow doesn't show. So on picture format, we're going to go ahead and crop, and we're going to move over here. I'm going to go ahead and put it right there. Perfect. That's going to look great. Now we're going to duplicate this slide to slide number 3, duplicate slide. And now here is where I'm going to crop it so that we move with the image. And I'm just going to put it to that point right there at the end of the arrow. And then we're going to move the photo as well. So it should move all together. So let's go ahead and preview this and see what happens. Let's go back to our transitions tab, preview. Yes, now that looks perfect. Now let's go ahead and play this in slideshow mode and look at the sequence. We're gonna go ahead, slide number 1, slide number 2, it's gonna grow, no shapes appear, and now slide number 3, that beautiful graphic slider. So that is what we had to do, just those 3 slides. Make sure that everything is on slide number 1. We have just the arrow shape, the background photo image to hide everything, and the photo. We're gonna grow the photo like we normally would, but make sure that you're also growing the little pentagons there in the background, and then you re-layer that photo so that the photo is on top of that arrow so that it kind of hides it behind the scenes. Make sure that that layering is the same on slide number 1 and slide number 2, and then you're going to go ahead and you're going to crop that photo on slide number 2 and then crop it even more on slide number 3 so that it has that really smooth effect and you don't see any of the shapes in the final product. So let's do this one more time. We're going to do slide number 1, it grows, and then we're going to go over with a really nice little slider effect. All right, Yuri, so that might have been a little complicated to get through, but it just shows you, make sure that you're making use of that selection pane, and if you get stuck, just kind of reorder things around this along the slide and just test things with morph as you go. You can always click the undo button, and you can always kind of go back and sort of figure out what you did and kind of piece things apart piece by piece as you work through some of these more complicated morph sequences. So I hope that you like this video. If anyone else out there liked this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. And if you like to join my channel, it's $1.99 a month, you will get priority access to these videos as I post them. I usually post a few videos a week, and one video per week gets posted publicly, but then you also get priority access to me. So if you have a question about something you're trying to accomplish in PowerPoint, I would be more than happy to either create one of these videos for you or kind of work with you to see if I might be able to help you out with that. So I hope you all have a great day. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.